Elijah on Mount Carmel, 1 Kings 18:1 through 19:18. It had not rained in Israel for 3 years. God told the prophet Elijah to meet with Israel's evil king Ahab. God said he would send rain. Ahab wasn't pleased to see Elijah. "So you're the troublemaker," Ahab said. "You're the troublemaker," Elijah replied. "You and your family have chosen to worship Baal, a false god." Elijah challenged Ahab to meet him on Mount Carmel and bring along 450 prophets of Baal and 400 prophets of another false god that the queen worshipped. Ahab was to command the people of Israel to come too. At Mount Carmel, Elijah spoke to the people. "How long will it take you to make up your mind? If the Lord is God, then follow him. But if it's Baal, follow him. I am the only prophet of God, but there are 450 of Baal's prophet. We will each make a sacrifice, but we will not burn them. We will pray, and the God who sends fire to burn the sacrifice is the true God." The people agreed. Elijah instructed the prophets of Baal to prepare a bull for their sacrifice. So the prophets of Baal built their altar and prepared the sacrifice. Now it was time for their God to light the fire. "O Baal, answer us," they cried, "answer us and light the sacrifice." They called out all morning, no fire came. They danced around the altar, but no fire came. By noon, Elijah started mocking. "Shout louder. Maybe Baal is off thinking, or busy, or on vacation. Perhaps he's asleep. You must wake him." Baal's prophets cried louder. They cut themselves to get Baal's attention, but nothing happened. So Elijah took his turn. First, he repaired the altar of the Lord, placing 12 stones, one for each tribe of Israel. Then he dug a trench around the altar. Finally, he laid the wood and the sacrifice on the altar. "Fill 4 water pots and pour water over everything," Elijah instructed. "Do it 3 times." Everything was soaked. Even the trench was full of water. "God," Elijah prayed, "show everyone that you are the one true God. I am your servant and I have obeyed you. Turn Israel's heart back to you." Then with a great whoosh, fire from God came down and burned up everything. The sacrifice, the wood, the stones, the dirt, and even the water in the trench. The people were stunned. They fell on their faces saying, "The Lord, he is God." "Seize the prophets of Baal," Elijah ordered. "Don't let them escape." The people took the false prophets to the brook, and Elijah killed them. Elijah told King Ahab, "Go home. It is going to rain." Ahab prepared to go, but Elijah knelt down and prayed. When it had not rained, he told his servant, "Look toward the sea. Do you see anything?" "Nothing," the servant answered. "Look again," Elijah said. The servant replied, "Still nothing." Elijah's servant looked 7 times. The 7th time he said, "I see a cloud no bigger than a man's hand. Hurry, tell King Ahab to get his chariot down from the mountain before it rains so hard he won't be able to," Elijah instructed. Dark clouds filled the sky, the wind picked up, and heavy rain fell. It was the first rain in 3 years. When Queen Jezebel heard that Elijah had killed the prophets of Baal, she sent a message to Elijah. "By this time tomorrow, you will be just as dead as those prophets." Elijah ran for his life. As he sat under a bush in the wilderness, Elijah prayed that God would kill him. "I've had enough, Lord," Elijah prayed. "Take my life." Exhausted, he fell asleep. God's angel woke Elijah and gave him food and water. Elijah slept again. The angel returned with another meal. Now Elijah had strength to journey 40 days to Mount Horeb, where he hid in a cave. "What are you doing here, Elijah?" God asked. "I've worked hard for you," Elijah responded, "but your people haven't honored their covenant to you. They've torn down your altars and killed your prophets. I'm the only prophet left, and they want to kill me too." "Stand outside the cave," God instructed, "and I, the Lord God, will pass by." A powerful wind tore at the mountainside and shattered rocks, but God was not in the wind. Then an earthquake shook the mountain, but God was not in the earthquake. After that came terrible fire, but God was not in the fire. Soon Elijah heard a whisper. He pulled his cloak over his face and stood at the front of the cave. "Now tell me, Elijah," the quiet voice said, "what are you doing here?" "I faithfully served you," Elijah answered again, "but the people of Israel don't want to worship you. I'm the only prophet left, and they want to kill me. Go back through the wilderness, God instructed. Anoint Elisha as my prophet after you, and know that you're not alone. 7,000 people have refused to worship Baal. Elijah learned to rely on God. We can rely on God too. He is as faithful today as he was in Elijah's day. We can be sure that God will never leave us.